Question number 131 states that diversity within a community is. So diversity within a community is alpha diversity. Diversity between two communities. Beta diversity is the diversity between two communities. And diversity of a region is called as gamma diversity. So diversity within a region is the alpha diversity. Diversity between the two regions is the beta diversity. And the diversity of a region is called as gamma diversity. So correct answer for this question is option number 1. Okay, moving on to the next question, that is question number 132. Question number 132 states that what percentage of offsprings would have genotype capital A, small b, capital C, capital D, small d, if the parents have the genotype capital A, small a, capital B, small c, and capital D, small d, is crossed with the capital A, small a, small b, capital C, capital D, small d. So calculate the percentage of this particular genotype. Now let's take the help of monohybrid cross. Capital A, small a, and capital A, small a. And we have to find the probability of capital A, small a. So the genotype of the offsprings will be this. And the probability of capital A, small a is 1 by 2. Then comes to capital B, crossed with small b. Here, the possible genotypes of the offspring is this. So the probability of small b is 1 by 2. Then let's talk about the third, small c and capital C, small c. Here we have to find out the probability of capital C, small c. The genotype of the offsprings will be either capital C, small c or small c. So the probability of capital C, small c is 1 by 2. Then let's talk about the next is capital D, small d crossed with capital D, small d. Okay, and we have to find out the probability of capital D, small d. So here the probability will be same, 1 by 2. This case is similar to this case. So the probability will be same. So this comes out to be 1 by 32. So as we have to find out the percentage, so 1 by 32 multiplied by 100, this comes out to be 6.25%. So the correct answer for this question is option number 2. I hope you have understood. Moving on to the next question, that is question number 133. Question number 133 states that read the following statements and find out the correct ones. Statement A, occasionally a single gene product may produce more than one effect. This is very true. Dominance is an autonomous feature of a gene. This is incorrect. It is not an autonomous feature of a gene. Okay. Frequency of recombination does not exceed 50% when two genes assort independently. This is very true. The frequency of recombination can never exceed 50%. So this is very true. F2 dihybrid test cross ratio is 1:1:1:1 when genes are linked completely. As genes are linked completely, so the F2 dihybrid ratio will be 1:1. So this is incorrect option. So the correct statements are A and C. So answer to this question is option number 1. Moving on to the next question, that is question number 134. Question number 134 states that in prokaryotes, the translation can begin much before the mRNA is fully transcribed, known as coupled condition. This is because of, see, what happens in prokaryotes, there is no nuclear membrane, membrane-bound organelles are absent. So when there is transcription is carried out, at that time, translation starts even when the transcription has not completed yet. Okay, translation tabhi start ho jata hai, jab transcription chal raha hai, tabhi translation bhi start ho jata hai. So there is no separation of transcription and translation in terms of time and space. Okay, so in prokaryotes, these two processes, that is transcription and translation, are said to be coupled because there is no separation of transcription and translation sites as both occur in cytosol. This is very true. The mRNA does not require any processing to become active. This is very true. This is the reason that why transcription and translation are said to be coupled condition in prokaryotes. Only one type of RNA polymerase can transcribe all the three RNAs. This statement is true for prokaryotes, but this is not the correct reason that why transcription and translation is said to be coupled. So this is incorrect statement. Statement D is, RNA polymerase associates transiently with initiation and termination factors. This statement is not true reason that why transcription and translation is said to be coupled in prokaryotes. So the correct reason is A and B. So answer to this question is option number 1. Moving on to the next question, that is question number 135. Question number 135 states that calculate the number of base pairs if length of DNA is 1.7 meter. See, length of DNA can be calculated by number of base pairs multiplied by distance between two consecutive base pairs. See, now in the question we are given with the length of the DNA, that is 1.7 meter. And we have to find out the number of base pairs. The distance between two consecutive base pairs is 0.34 nanometer. 0.34 nanometer can be written as 0.34 into 10 raised to the power minus 9 meter. So, now you have to calculate the number of base pair. So, 1.7 meter upon 0.34 into 10 raised to the power minus 9 meter. 70 upon 34 multiply by 100 multiply by 10 and 10 raised to the power 9. Okay, now see. So this comes out to be 5 into 10 raised to the power 9 base pair. So answer to this question is option number 3. I hope you have understood. This was all for today. Thank you.